Hello everyone, myself Monisha Charya and I'm legal intern at Lexis & Company. Today I'm here to talk to you about the topic, or I can say that today I will tell you all about the mediation. Yes, the mediation process. So basically, what is mediation? Mediation is a confidential process by which a neutral who is acting as a mediator, who is selected by the parties or appointed by the court, help in the litigation process so that it can reach the mutual acceptable agreement. Mediation is basically a process of alternative dispute resolution in which a neutral third party, the mediator, assists two or more parties in order to help them negotiate an agreement with concentrate effect and matter of common interest. So basically, mediation means when two parties have some issues and with an easy way they negotiate with each other and reach to a final decision and sign an agreement or order to say that yes, they will follow this decision. Who is mediator and who can appoint a mediator? A mediator is a third party person who solves the dispute. Parties are free to agree on the name of mediator, or you know, if parties can agree that the party can bring their own mediator and both the party can agree that yes, this is a person who can mediate for us, or the court itself appoint the mediator and party have to agree to go to that mediator and to solve the case. And who can be appointed as a mediator? Any person other than a person who has been adjudged as insolvent or against whom criminal charges involving moral turpitude are framed by a criminal court. Person who have been convicted by a criminal court for any offense involving moral problems or moral values. Person against whom disciplinary proceedings have been initiated by the appropriate disciplinary authority. A person who is interested or connected with the subject matter of the dispute. Any legal practitioner who has or is appearing for any of the parties in the dispute. So these are the people who cannot be a mediator in any case. So basically, what are the characteristics of the mediation? It brings neutrality, separate people from the problem easily, motivating negotiator, and it is less time consuming, and order or decision is taken very quickly. Role of mediator. So what is the role of mediator who mediate for the parties? The mediator shall attempt to facilitate voluntary resolution of the dispute by the parties and communicate the view of each party to the other, assist them in identifying the issue, reducing the misunderstanding, clarifying the priorities, exploring areas of compromise and gathering option in an attempt to solve the dispute, emphasizing that it is the responsibility of the parties to take decision which affect them. He shall not impose any terms of settlement on the parties. So what are the advantages of mediation? If mediation followed not set procedure, result in no assumed outcomes and cannot compel parties to agree unless those people or those parties wish to do so. What advantages are there for mediation? So basically, in mediation, if any decision comes out, then it is on the parties, whether to follow it or not. And mediation's advantages are: mediation is relatively inexpensive, mediation is relatively swift, Mediation does not run by a court schedule and session can be easily scheduled anytime at the mutual convenience of the parties and the mediator and can take place in a variety of location. Mediation is relatively simple. There is no complex procedure or evidentiary rule which must be followed. Mediation allow the parties to revise and adjust the scope of their conflict in mediation center. As circumstances changes, so can the topic of the decision. The increased flexibility make it easier for the negotiator to act as a problem solver instead of advisories. Then what are the errors of mediation? Some of the typically mentioned disadvantages are: mediation does not always result in settlement agreement. Parties might spend their time and money in mediation only to find that they must have their case settled for them by a court. Opting for mediation therefore presents something of a risk. Further, if mediation fails, much of parties' ammunition might have already been exposed to the opposing party, thereby becoming far less useful in the ensuring trials. So these are the mediation disadvantages. Settlement agreement. When it appears to the conciliator that there exists element of settlement which may be acceptable to the parties, he shall formulate the terms of possible settlements and submit them to the parties for their observations. After receiving the observation of the parties, the conciliator may reformulate the terms of the possible settlement in the light of such observation. If the parties reach agreement on a settlement of the dispute, they may draw up and sign up the settlement agreement. So basically, mediation is a process in which you can negotiate between the two parties and make them or give them a final decision that they have to follow, and it is the party wish that whether they want to implement them that decision on themselves or not. And if in case they don't want to implement it, they can go to the trial for to the court for the further trials and for the process. So these are the things we should know about the mediation. So successful mediation programs in India were Bangalore Mediation Center, Salim Advocate Bar Association case, mediation rules framed unsuccessful, IDLS training of program and judge and mediator, workshop, booklets, documentary, mediation week, all are these programs that are held time to time in India so that the alternative dispute resolution alternative method could become easy for the Indian people than rather than going to the courts. I hope you have understood this topic. For more such topics and information, subscribe to our channel and do not forget to share, like and comment. Thank you.